Yo, what's up guys, it's DJ Rick Webb back in the studio office, and remember when I said I was going to make a 2018 like recap video? Well, that went out the door because got busy with the company. So this is my little like update video for you guys in terms of where we're at in 2018 and where we're going. In this update video, I'm gonna talk about both YouTube, what I'm doing on YouTube, what's happening with the YouTube channel, and also I want to document Fusion Sound and Lighting because I think this is a very important thing for this channel for me to document this company. As you guys know, I just started this company. I launched it January of 2018 and we didn't start doing gigs until August of 2018. So this company is very new and it's my own company. It's like the first time I'm ever doing this and stuff. So it's all a learning process and I wanna document it and show you guys so you guys don't make the same mistakes. First off, I wanna talk just quickly a little bit about 2018. 2018 for me was just like a crazy mess, ginormous changes in my life. Like, things went crazy in 2018, honestly. So let me just run through some of the bigger milestones that happened in 2018. One, DJ Bar came for the first time, we collabed for the first time, and we've done multiple collabs since then. I graduated college. That's a huge step right there. I graduated college with a mechanical engineering degree from Ohio University. Because I graduated college, I had a full-time job. The full-time job was in a brand new state, so I moved states. I moved from Ohio to where I am now in North Carolina. I got a new apartment. I got a brand new truck. I got a brand new job. A lot of stuff changed. And my whole Fusion Sound Lighting company, I knew I was going to be moving down here and I knew I was going to have this job before I even started my senior year of college. So that's why I launched Fusion Sound Lighting in 2018, preparing for when I would move down here to try and get business rolling before I actually got down here. And that worked somewhat. To sum up 2018 in a very quick consensus way, it was a mess and just a lot of changes. I literally feel finally now in late February of 2019, after being down here for what, 7-8 months now, I finally feel that I'm like settling out finally. So now let's talk about 2019 and YouTube in specific. What is going on with this YouTube channel? First off, gotta welcome the over 13,000 new subscribers since the beginning of 2018. Welcome to the channel. Because of the whole like starting my own DJ company, and this is a multi-op DJ company, I have two other DJs. Previously, I was working for a company, so owning my own company, running my own company, and handling all the back-end stuff has been the most time-consuming thing in the world until lately when I've implemented a couple new systems and programs that I'm gonna be showing you guys in upcoming videos. But it's really cut into a lot of my time that I spent working on content for this YouTube channel. So because of that, I decided to hire a full-time video editor. I had a part-time, but now I have a full-time video editor and a part-time video editor. And his name is Joe. Joe, go ahead, insert picture or whatever the heck you wanna do here. Joe's editing the video right now.
Yo, what's up guys, I'm Joe, I'm the editor. I just wanna say something real quick. If you're not subscribed to DJ Rick Webb, I don't know what you're doing, go down. If that subscribe button says subscribe and not subscribe, duh, you're doing something wrong. Enough of me talking, I don't even know if this is gonna be kept in the video. If it is, what's up you guys, I'm Joe, back to DJ Rick Webb. Peace.
His link to his YouTube channel is right here. It's also in the description down below. You can go check out Joe. He's also a YouTuber, does kind of like whatever you call it, Joe. Skits, comedy, I don't know what he does. The main reason for adding Joe is the main thing I spent time on for this YouTube was editing. And honestly, I was getting to the point where I hated editing these videos. It was just a pain for me. I didn't enjoy it anymore. I enjoy filming these videos. That's fun. That's creative. It's awesome. But I just like, from an editing standpoint, I was starting to just hate it. So, Joe has completely revamped this channel. If you've seen, I have a new logo now. I have new intro and outro graphics. The graphics are overall cooler. The videos are cooler. Background music, all that cool video nonsense. Explosions. With that said, there's going to be a heavy focus to push out content. You guys have probably seen that in the past 2 weeks. We've been trying to push out at least 2 videos every single week, which means I'm filming a lot, he's editing a lot, and we're getting a lot of stuff done. We're gonna be focusing a lot on lighting, so I'm starting a whole lighting series here in the coming month. I'm gonna be starting a sound series, and I'm also gonna be starting a lot of documentation on business. how I run my business, how I found most effective marketing, advertisement, all kinds of stuff like that. I'm gonna be making videos on, because honestly, I've learned a lot. And I'll comment a little bit about that in the Fusion Sound and Lighting part of this video. One last thing here on the YouTube channel. Joe is an editor. Joe costs money for me to edit these videos. Also, YouTube has been wonderful and has been throwing some copy flag strikes at some of my videos lately. AKA, your boy's not making much money off of YouTube. So I've created a Patreon page. The Patreon is linked in the description down below. If you wish to support the channel, I would appreciate 100%. But if you would like to support the channel, support the content that I'm making, support everything about this whole giving back to beginners and DJs out there that I'm trying to do on this channel, the link to the Patreon page is in the description down below. All right, so now at this point in the video, I wanna give you guys an update on Fusion Sound and Lighting. Cause like I said earlier, this company is a brand new company for you guys that don't know. I launched this company in January of 2018 in North Carolina, but I wasn't in North Carolina. I didn't move down here until May, and I didn't start doing any events or gigs or anything until August, well, no, September, no, October. We didn't start doing anything in North Carolina until October, but I actually moved down here in May. So you could basically say 2018 was a startup year with like no gigs. So with that said, I want to document on this YouTube channel the whole progress of the company, where we're at, how, where we're going, what we're doing, all that fun stuff. One thing I can tell you is I never want to have a 2018 ever again. From the period of May when I graduated college and moved down here all the way till October when we actually started doing events again at a decent rate, I was like losing my mind not being able to DJ every single weekend. But anyways, we're in 2019 now, so that's not gonna happen. So on a business model standpoint right now, Fusion Sound and Lighting is kind of more or less a higher end wedding DJ service, and also I have a major focus on doing advanced lighting elements at weddings. So ceiling washes, string bulb lighting, all kinds of like technical lighting. I really want to push that as being like the brand for Fusion Sound and Lighting. And also I want to have a separate division doing schools, because as you guys know, I like doing these big blown out school dances. So that's a major focus for me, is doing these major big production school dances, doing weddings. And overall, as you can tell with that, the overall goal is to have a production side of the company. So right now where we're at in the whole entire business model phase, I call it the phase that we're in right now. It's the first year, it's the experiment. So with it being the experiment year, I'm experimenting like crazy. Just to give you guys a reference on how much I'm experimenting, I dropped $6,000 just in January on marketing and advertisement strategies. And the whole goal of doing all this experimenting in 2019, trying out different marketing strategies, trying out different advertisement strategies, trying out different brochures, different clients, different wedding planning services, all this stuff, is to figure out what works. And I think this is going to be very beneficial when I start actually noticing what's working and what's not working, to show you guys and to tell you guys on this YouTube channel, so that way you guys can actually know what's actually working out there, what marketing strategies are working, what are the millennials, that the brides that you're targeting, what are they actually looking for at school dances, what do you need to do? And overall, with all these marketing and advertisement strategies, is to try and book like a ton of weddings, as many weddings as I possibly can book, because it's gonna get the ball rolling on the referral thing. As you guys know, the biggest way that we get leads and the biggest way that we gain clients year after year is referrals from past clients. So now, because I'm completely open on this channel with like what's going on with my business, I'm not trying to hide stuff from you, I'm not trying to tell anything from you guys. I wanna give you guys a little bit of numbers on the company, where we're at. I'm not gonna give you financial numbers, I'll give you like events booked and all that. I'm probably never gonna give you financial numbers other than like being like, I spent $10,000 on equipment, I spent $6,000 on advertisements. So back in December of 2018, I set forth the business plan, the business goals for 2019 for the company. And the main goal was to hit 25 weddings booked between me, Kaylin, and Oscar. If you guys didn't know, I have Oscar, he's a bilingual DJ. Pretty awesome that I have that market available to me. I have Kaylin, who is, you guys know Kaylin. And then you have me. So between the three of us, I did not expect to book Oscar like any at all. Did not expect to make Kaylin much at all. My main goal was to get me booked, and to get me booked a lot of weddings, and to get Kaylin booked on any dates that I've already been booked on. So goal is to hit 25 weddings, and we've hit 17 as of yesterday. So we're already on our way to pretty much surpassing that goal in 2019, which I'm extremely excited about, because when I made that goal, it was kind of just like throwing a number on a dartboard and hoping it sticks. On the school dance portion, because you guys know school dances is like the second, or if not the biggest part of the business that I try to push, I wanted to do 10 total school dances in 2019, and the main focus to get at least 5 schools down here in purely North Carolina. As you guys know, I did a lot of schools in Ohio, and a lot of schools in Ohio are still like paying the amount of money that I'm requesting to go back and do their dances. And so far, with that said, we're moving into prom season and we have 5 schools booked. 2 of those schools are in North Carolina specifically. If one of those schools is going to be having a prom of 800 kids or more. One more thing on numbers, I kind of want to express the importance of numbers and having business models and having business plans in place, because if you don't, you might lose a lot of money in a year. Speaking of numbers, let's talk about equipment. One, I'm not going to talk about the money spent on equipment because it's a lot. But as you guys know, I spent a lot of money on equipment in 2018, and a lot of that was prepping for events that we're doing in 2019. And you guys will see here at the beginning of 2019, I'm also going to, and actually throughout 2019, I'm going to be dropping a lot of money on equipment. And the main reasons for dropping a lot of money on equipment, one thing, there was equipment that I didn't really realize I needed to actually have my own company, so there was money spent on equipment in that mindset. 2, I actually offer a lot of services that I don't have equipment for because I tend to rent. As you guys know, I've expressed this multiple times, you do not have the money for something, you rent it. Unless the rental fee is stupid expensive, which I can tell you right now, down here in North Carolina, the rental houses here for the production stuff that I want to like rent is absolutely insane. Thankfully, I have good connections with DJs down here that I can actually rent gear from other DJs. But the problem with doing that is it's other DJs. They might also need to be using that equipment. I've budgeted basically the budget I made for 2019. Basically, it's gonna be a draw. I'm not gonna make any money. I'm not gonna lose any money. So yeah, so let's be thankful I have a full-time job. So that kind of gives you a little mindset or background behind all the equipment you're gonna be seeing me buy and all the equipment that I've already bought. You basically can know that basically I'm spending all the profits that I'm making on DJing to pay for all this equipment. But as you guys can tell, that means it's all gonna be paid off, and that means next year is gonna be completely profit. So I hope this wasn't too long of an overall update on where 2019 I'm at on YouTube and Fusion Sound Lighting. I am beyond excited for 2019. You literally cannot express how, or I cannot express how excited I am for 2019. Like, I wake up every morning with like the attitude of let's do it, let's get it, let's go. And that mostly comes around the drive of my own company, because as you guys know, long term, my goal is to only be doing DJing. I want to be running this company solely. I don't want to have a full-time job. I want to be doing this full-time. I am beyond excited to like push this company, to push the boundaries. I can't even really put it into words. The drive and the energy I feel around this company, Fusion Sound Lighting, every day when, and I'm working on this company, when I'm booking a client, when I see a new client sign a contract, when I see a new invoice was paid, it just like takes my energy day after day and just bumps it up one more notch. I hope that through this YouTube channel, I can also encourage you guys that with your own DJ business and with your own DJ pursuits, if this is a passion for you guys, I hope you guys can find that drive that I have found lately to push them boundaries, to work your ass off every single day, to put in the hours and to do work. But anyways guys, with that said, leave down in the comment section down below what you guys are doing for 2019. If you have any comments on what I'm doing, maybe some suggestions, goals, or just some general questions. As you guys know, I answer every single question that's down in the comment section, but down below, as long as they're not stupid. If you like this video, be sure to give it a big thumbs up. If you're not already subscribed, be sure to click that subscribe button. And if you want to become an awesome supporter of this channel, be sure to click the link to that Patreon page in the description down below. But like always, guys, my name is Dedrick Webb. Keep them records spinning, and I will see you guys next time. Peace.